It's a weird vehicle. It's a weird race car. We're going to do some weird stuff, but in the end of the day, it's the name of science. It should work, but we'll find out.
We got our Fox running. We swapped a Jetta drivetrain into it. We took it to a test day and it passed with flying colors. And now we are on our way to Barber Motorsports Park for the Shine Country Classic, our first 24 hours of Lemons race with the car. On our way though is Nine Lives Racing. They build race cars, mostly race car aero, right? Johnny Chakowski.
Correct, yeah.
He said, stop by our shop. Not only will I help you finish up a few of the things that were left after the test day, I will put a big wing on the car. So we're going to put a big wing on the car, we're going to button up a few odds and ends, and then we're going to go racing.
Really big. So, guess first impressions?
Yeah.
Is what we're looking for? It's here.
Some race cars, Nissan DeltaWing comes to mind. You know, they aren't appreciated at first, but then it's their track record and, you know, the mark they leave on history that makes them remembered and respected. And we think our Fox will be similar to that. This is basically the DeltaWing.
DeltaWing never won a race?
No, it's going to get crashed into a lot.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we need to take the bumper off?
Yeah.
It's interesting what skills each team member brings to the equation. Johnny's really good at aerodynamics. I'm really good at telling Johnny no when he tries to put extra wings on the car. Chris shoots video.
Wait, are you really good at that? It looks like we're putting extra wings on the car.
We're not putting more than that one extra wing on the car.
I mean, we could put a little spoiler in the back.
Do you have any power tools? You know, I literally have a truck full of power tools.
Yeah. So while we're putting the wing on the car, as you can see here, Tom, thank you. Wing's nothing more than an aerodynamic device. As the air travels around it and over it, it creates a pressure zone, pressure differential between the top and the bottom, and the bottom of the wing will actually start to, lack of a better word, suck, and it'll pull the whole apparatus down. Our basic wing like this can, at about 140 miles an hour, do about 300 pounds of downforce.
Does the Fox go 140?
Yes. Depends who's driving is the limit of our Fox, but to be all honest, what we're doing here and why we're putting it on the front is what you want to do is have the weight distribution of the vehicle match the aero distribution of the vehicle. On this particular vehicle, everything is in front of the front axle, so it makes it almost no sense to put a wing on the back. It's a weird vehicle, it's a weird race car, we're going to do some weird stuff, but in the end of the day, it's the name of science. It should work, but we'll find out.
Yeah,
we haven't blamed Jesse yet. Uh-oh.
Okay, in order to mount a wing, we need uprights. This is a Nine Lives Racing upright off of a Corvette. And we were hoping that the bumper beam would be solid enough we could just bolt it right up there, but it's not, so we're gonna have to reinforce the front bumper structure a little bit to have something to bolt to.
Or we might be able to use this.
Do you have any self-tapping screws?
Stop that.
So we are going to try using this bumper, see if it's sturdy enough to mount a wing to. So we got to pull the metal bumper beam out of the plastic bumper. Oh, you have power tools.
Power tools.
Yeah.
Try it. Hey, remember that thing you said about it being painted?
It's painted.
Well, you're stomping on it.
Well, I don't have anything. Too bad you don't have any cardboard we could set it on.
All right. I need to see the bottom of the bumper. Because there's holes for screws. Substantially.
Screw machine broke.
It just gave up.
Out of here.
This one had some lunch instead. Hey!
Let's get this out of harm's way.
Yeah. We only opened about a year ago. It's cool to kind of look back in time. Just a year to see how far we've come, which is, I find it enjoyable. And now I get to stare at it the entire time we're racing. Like that. Oh, good news. You can get to it on the backside.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, that's nice. That's rare in my occupation. All right, so Sharpie, we definitely need to put lights on this.
Lights on the car?
No, on the mount.
Okay.
AC highlighters.
Uh-huh.
I have a set on the bench at home, and I didn't bring them because I didn't want to overcomplicate the mission.
But it would be so cool.
We're already going to get penalty laps.
No, we're not.
We just went from competitive to not at all by thinking about the wing.
Ta-da. You ready?
Oh yeah, rear bolt first.
Rear bolt first.
Can you see under it?
It's perfect.
Is it?
Come here.
Can you see under it?
Oh my God. I can already see underneath it.
Yeah.
Even the cargo. Why is it so funny from in here? It's hilarious. I look through here and I think, like, Roadrunner, you know, like, yeah. But hey, so like I'm behind a Roadrunner.
What stops it from doing this all the time?
Well, none of the bolts are tight.
Yeah, but I mean, what stops it from wiggling once they're tight?
Oh, it wiggles.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
Let's crank her down. So wait, there's one last step. When you put a Nine Lives Racing wing on a car. Oh, this is sketchy.
Holy cow.
Is this okay?
I'm watching your frame rails move.
Really?
Yes. No,
the whole bumper is bending because we mounted to the sheet metal bumper and not to anything strong.
No, I mean like the stuff that's going into the frame, I see it moving. That looks good to me.
I'm only 150 pounds.
Well, we're only gonna go like 30 miles an hour.
How much downforce does this make again?
At 140?
No, at 100.
130 pounds.
So this is okay?
Yeah.
You sure about this?
Yeah. Look at you.
Okay.
Look at him.
You have to remeasure the AOA because I just changed it 20 degrees.
No, it's good enough. So, well, we're excited. Why we're excited, we don't really know. But, so what we're going to do is we kind of thought we should make a theme being the wings because the nose wing is such a very prominent piece, I guess you could say. And so we need to put something on the back. Oh, shut up. So we need to put something on the back. And so what we're gonna do is, instead of just putting a normal wing in, so we're gonna do a dual, like a biplane style, where it's one wing on top of the other one. Frankly, I don't think any clean air is gonna get back there, so I don't think it's gonna actually do anything, but it's gonna add to the, the big prominence of having a giant wing back there. So that's kind of what we're doing. And right here, we ran out of scrap wings, and the scrap wing we have is very small. So what we took is two cutoffs, and we're gonna weld them together right in the middle. And that way we have our two upper and lower deck elements. That way we have two at about 40 inches wide. So it's gonna be dumb.
The steering shaft on the Fox is really messy and awkwardly mounted at an angle. We think if we just take the quick disconnect off the wheel, it'll take about 2 minutes, and it'll move the wheel a little further down and a little further away from the drivers and make it so our shorter guys can see over the wheel. Okay, a couple hours in the Nine Lives Racing shop, and we have 1, 2, and 3 wings on our Fox, making it totally ready for a wacky lemons field. Bonus points though, we think these will actually work and make it faster, right? You figuring 3 or 4 seconds a lap?
It's gonna be fun to play with it, find out, especially this guy.
Yeah, I think the front wing will really make a difference.
Yeah, we're gonna try it taking the wing off, running, putting it on, and then if it goes faster with the wing on, we're gonna add gurney flaps and dual element kits to it, just to see how much drag does it take,
and how much
to make car go slower,
and how much we can get away with before the lemons judges black flag us and give us more penalty laps.
That's your problem.
Yeah. While we were here, we also fixed our steering wheel issue, so now you can actually see what you're doing when you're driving, and we put the fire system in the car too. So we have a few more things to wrap up in the morning, and then we're gonna go racing. We just got to Barber Motorsports Park, home of the Shine Country Classic, the first 24 hours of lemons event of the season, and we have got to put some stickers on our car, get it through tech, and see if they fail us. It's gonna be awesome. things are coming together nicely. We're just putting the last couple stickers on the car here. About to take it down to tech, and we're hoping, we think it's going to pass tech with no issues. So we'll do that, and then be back and get ready for tomorrow. Okay, we just finished tech inspection and what Lemons calls BS inspection, which is where they figure out if you're cheating or not. Surprisingly, they determined that we weren't cheating, and they said that we get to be in the slowest class with zero penalty laps, which means that if our Fox doesn't blow up, we have a shot at actually placing mid-pack, we'll be honest. But it's a good result. Glad we didn't get penalty laps. See what happens tomorrow.
Support brands that support Grassroots Motorsports. Get your chemical solutions from CRC Industries. Visit crcindustries.com to learn more.